Welcome to the BoshNRoll channel. If you want to support my daily eternal magic offerings while getting amazing perks like the BoshNRoll Discord community, have me play your deck on the channel, or listen to sideboard guides before tournaments, check out the Patreon or YouTube membership program. This channel is possible because of these amazing sponsors. Check them out. All their links are in the video description. As always, thanks for being here. Let's go play some magic. Welcome back to the BoshNRoll channel. Today, I'm testing for Eternal Weekend. This video brought to you by no Patreon subscribers. I'm doing my own work here today. If you've been following the channel the last week or so, you've seen me play a bunch of different random decks that I had on my shortlist for Eternal Weekend. This is my default. This is the Pokemoki Sultai Beanstalk deck. I had a targeted testing league with Pokemoki on the channel the other day, where I played the five-color Beanstalk deck versus the Sultai one. And basically, he rinsed me, just swept the floor with me with this deck. And I like that because beating Beanstalks soup is an important thing you're going to have to do at Eternal Weekend. This deck seems really good against combo as well, with its seven free permission spells plus Thoughtseize. There's a lot to like about that. My concern is the initiative, which I imagine, or I don't need to imagine, Pokemoki has told me, is one of the most concerning matchups for this deck. We do have Force of Wills, Removal, Wastelands, Orcish Bowmaster as two creatures that can take the initiative, but we're doing kind of some weird stuff in the sideboard to try to improve that. Turok, Dread Cantor, Protection from White, that can just be a sticky thing against the initiative that takes it and then hangs back, or keeps bashing depending on how the board shakes out. And then this one, Pokemoki actually messaged me like first thing this morning, like, this is probably too cute, but I could see it being good. 1-1 Flying Lifelink. When Deep Cavern Bat enters a battlefield, look at target opponent's hand. You may exile a non-land card from it until Bat leaves the battlefield. Basically, this is an evasive Thoughtseize. So you get to take a card from their hand, and then you have a thing that can poke and take the initiative. I don't know if this is better than a pro white creature like Turok. I don't know if this is better than like Dress Down or Subtlety, as far as stopping the initiative from showing up, but we are a deck with removal, but we're not a deck that can always take the initiative, because Orcish Bowmasters are only really high-velocity threat. It's also one Stifle in the main deck that can stop the initiative from entering the game in the first place, at least on the first creature that has it. We're trying to solve a hammer-level problem in the metagame with a series of pillows, basically. Just a bunch of little ways to deflect what that deck's doing and hoping we can eke out advantage and steal it against them. But conceptually, that is a tough matchup for us. And that is a deck that it is very important to me to be able to beat if we're going into a 11-round Swiss tournament plus top 8. I imagine we'll see that deck. Gotta beat it. If you see it, you don't get many losses in a Swiss tournament. It's exactly one. And I don't want to waste it on the initiative. Those are my thoughts about this specific list. As far as the deck itself, it's just a Beanstalk card advantage deck. We have a bunch of Murktides, Murderous Cuts, Learner Fields, Force of Wills to trigger the beans, and you can get low with Daze and Wasteland when you need to get low. You can go high with Beanstalk card advantage, and it's a really modal deck. Lots of little decisions. I like that. I like all the one and two ofs. They're really annoying to play around, take it from me. I just did a testing league against Pokemoki where all of these cards came up and you can never play around any of them. And this is my default. If I like this, I might just lock it in. I'm going to release this after Eternal Weekend either way to respect Pokemoki and his testing, but this is very high on my list. Let's hope this league goes well. I'm jumping in. I'm on the play against a Yorion with this three-of-a-kind Beanstalk grip. I am keeping this all day. I'm going to lead on the Misty Rainforest so I don't get wasted off my strat here, but I would like to bury my opponent in cards, and this is a good start to do that. My opponent said, hey YouTube, everyone say hi to Raven the Light. Appears we are actually doing Death and Taxes stuff, which is a great place to be with this Witherbloom command in my opening hand. I'm going to fetch an Underground Sea and just go off here. Destroy target non-creature permanent, target player mills 3, then you return a land. There is this weird thing that I have done in the past where when I'm playing against Death and Taxes, I mill them with Witherbloom Command because they don't usually use their graveyard. They do have some important one-ofs in their deck, and this sometimes comes down to decking. With the Murderous Cuts and Murktides in my deck, keeping my own graveyard flush is relevant, but I think I am still going to just do the mill you thing. I picked up Misty Rainforest. Umezawa's Jitte did go to their graveyard. No way they play two of those. I don't know if that's important, but it happened. Witherbloom Command is one of the strengths of this deck compared to the other versions. I had it in my four-color build at Eternal Weekend Prague, and it was just harder to cast when you're four colors, and you get multiple copies of this. You can loop it with Mystic Sanctuary as well. Very powerful tool. Opponent's got a fetch. The fact that we've seen three fetch lands already makes me think this is a multicolor version. As such, yep, there's Thalia. She dies to Orcish Bowmaster. I'm just going to put this down. Get my money where I can get it. All of this grinding towards a spot where I eventually murderous cut something with three Beanstalks in play. All right, well, Thoughtseize in your deck. Powerful. This is a huge eye roll, though. This is basically a full house. I have three card advantage engines and two removal spells. We're getting to work, taking one of the beans. Played a Wasteland that didn't use it. And I'm going to cast this Beanstalk from my hand. If I hit the land, play the other Beanstalk, that'll be a great way to use my turn. Or just find the fourth Beanstalk, that's cool too. Do I think they have Samwise? Why didn't they Wasteland me? All right, I'm going to attack for two here. And I'm going to fetch for Trop, Cycle Lorien Revealed for C. And just hit my land drop here. They know what I've got going on right now. I think killing this Aether Vial on turn two has locked them out of using Wasteland aggressively here. They kind of need the mana. Recruiter of the Guard. There it is. I wonder if they get like Bowmaster and try to punish this bean line. All right, they're getting Lorien and just trying to grind out the beans. I will go up the Beanstalk number three and up the Beanstalk number four because I am annoying like that. Play a land, and I'm going to attack with Orc Army Token. And I'm just going to pass the turn here. There is a third Underground Sea in my deck. I don't like this Thoughtseize. That can strip my Murderous Cut. Maybe I'm just supposed to cut in response and Ancestral Recall over the top of the Thoughtseize. But having Lorien Revealed, that's just draw six next turn, and I still have a bunch of removal spells besides. Yeah, they took the Lorien. Here's Lorien. Gonna destroy one of my beans. I'm gonna cut her in response. Underground Sea, Murderous Cut, target Lorien. I'm gonna leave Witherbloom Command and Lorien Revealed in my graveyard for my Mystic Sanctuary to pick up. That's so busted. Okay. Another Shoulders Edict. So they've already seen one. I'm actually not even convinced Bowmasters is good here. Like, they're not a deck that really draws cards, and if I can clear the way for Edict, that's better than just having this random Bowmaster in play. And now I can hardcast Force, which draws two cards on whatever they try to do this turn. If they just Wasteland me, then move through phases, I can Sauron's Ransom. Flicker Wisp. This deletes my Orc Army, but that's fine. It turns on my Fatal Push in so doing. And I can save Force of Will for something better later. End of turn, Sauron's Ransom. Oh, I think they misclicked. Whoops, they just made pile of four. I'll take it. Either that or they're playing to decking and they're just like, fuck it. Which I can't imagine is the case. Yeah, that's awkward. They said they misclicked. It was not their plan to deck me. Drawing this Witherbloom Command is interesting because that kills Flicker Wisp. And I can save my Fatal Push for something better. Can I get my hand below the requisite number of cards? Do I save this Witherbloom Command for something later? I could also just Edict. I'm not going to do that though. I'm just going to go to my turn. And accept that I'm likely to discard some cards here. Okay, Polluted Delta, fetch, get Tropical Island, or maybe I'll just get Basic Island. Yeah, it's fine. Then Witherbloom Command, -3/-1, target player mills three. I will once again mill them, or let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So if I mill me, I can double Murktide pass with Force Up. Yeah, that's the one. All right. Black, green. Gotta leave all my blue lands back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1. So I actually do get the land back here. I'll take the Wasteland. I'm going to draw a million cards right now. And I left all of the spells in my graveyard, and they should be extremely worried about what that means. And we just turn the corner and crush all in one turn here. Yeah, okay. I mean, that misclick on Sauron's Ransom was really bad, but that line was mostly set up anyway. Hard to take credit for that one. All right, Deed, Swamp, Turok definitely coming in. Force of Negation, Spell Pierce coming out, and a Force of Will. Seeing that they're a black deck with Thoughtseize, maybe I'm more interested in Veil of Summer than I would normally be against Taxes. I like that because of Witherbloom Command, you don't really need to bring in Force of Vigor in the matchup. A lot of control decks need a card like this to keep up with Aether Vial, but we just don't. I am not going to Veil of Summer here, though I think it would be reasonable. Important to note that the Deep Cavern Bat in my sideboard is over a Fatal Push. That's what I cut to make room for that. And Fatal Push would definitely come in here where Bat does not. I'm going to keep my hand. Arid Mesa. And I'm just going to pass here. If I Ponder Miss and get Wastelanded, that's bad. I can just cycle Lorien Revealed. Make sure my lands keep coming. If they play something like Thalia, I have the Bowmaster. Clean answer to that. They've successfully played around Daze with that Vial. Fetch. Going to get Underground Sea. And cycle for Tropical Island. I'll just lean into Wasteland. Come get me. I could Brainstorm here. Yeah, I'm going to Brainstorm, and then if I find a fetch land, great. If I don't, I can use Ponder to shuffle. Put back at least one of these Wastelands, maybe both. If they do fetch a dual land, though, this Arid Mesa does not get Basic Swamp, and I would love to get them with their own game here. Kind of like access to Force of Will, just in case. Maybe Daze, but Daze is a nice pitch to Force of Will. Okay, I'm going to put away a Wasteland, and I'm going to Ponder off of Underground Sea. This gives up the information that I'm holding Tropical Island. Just going to shuffle this. But they can't waste me off a single color here. There is a Wasteland. And a Fetch. Or a Scrubland. And me without my Wastelands anymore. Orcish Jabronis, they're in there. And I can just send Murktide. Oh, I could also play this Deed and just invest in the future. Yeah, Deed for 2 just completely stabilizes this board. I could also shove a Murktide for as a 6-6 right now. Now, I love this Pernicious Deed right now. Just put that into play. Mop up the Bowmasters, the Vial, everything, all in one big sweep. I could Force or Daze a Lorien if they try to pick this off. Vial's not at 3 yet. Oh yeah. Played around it. I guess if they had Vialed in Thalia, then played Lorien, they would have checkmated me there. But I was prepared for that possibility. If the Vial's on 2, I think I wait a turn on Deed until I can go bigger all at once. I'm going to pass into their turn. See if they Vial anything in the end step. Because if I just hold on to this Deed, are they going to have a Stifle? Oh, they could have Flickerwisp and remove their Bowmaster, I guess, but then Flickerwisp dies. Yeah, maybe I just gave them Flicker Wisp by waiting. My thought was I could take 2 in combat, and it's not a big deal. And then also Time Walk them. But Flicker Wisp does kind of meaningfully sidestep that. But then I can just untap and Bowmaster their Bowmaster plus Murktide with Force Backup. Yeah, I'm not actually even worried about that. Oh, I was supposed to flick... Nope, never mind. I was about to say I was supposed to do this main phase, because now their Bowmaster comes back in my end step. But that's fine, because it's gone. And then I play Murktide, and I can Bowmaster their Bowmaster in the end step. They are Vialing in response to Deed for 3. Recruiter. Getting a Bowmaster. Okay. So if I had Deeded on my turn or at the start of their turn, that situation would have been worse for me, because then they Vial in the Recruiter and then play a 3-drop in their main phase. This Thoughtseize is nice. I'd like a look at your hand, please. I'd like to take your answer to Murktide, and then I can Force your other card, and then we don't do anything anymore. And you die in big ol' 8-point chunks. Bowmaster can resolve. My hand answers that. Mom, Stoneforge, Skyclave. I'll take the Stoneforge. I don't care about Skyclave. Yep, 8-8 Murktide. I could have made it a 7 and kept Lauren Revealed my graveyard for Mystic Sanctuary. I don't think that's good, though. There's the mom. And a land that I don't care about. They're going to put Yorion in hand. Up the Beanstalk. Not super helpful here. I'm going to pick off the mom before it does anything. Just try to get them dead here. The Bowmaster is enough to dissuade me from playing this Beanstalk. They have a land. Do I even care about Yorion? Do I just let it resolve? Okay, so they're at 10. If I force the Yorion, they have to block my Bowmaster with Orc Army. Oh no, they're actually dead. Okay, I'm going to force because I have Mystic Sanctuary available. I'm going to force the Yorion, and then I attack with everything, and if they don't block with everything, they lose to Mystic Sanctuary here. Oh, they lose to that too. GG. I had a plan, but this is a better one. Target opponent loses 2 life. Target creature gets -3/-1. Cast it. Kill the Bowmaster, drain you. Yeah, the burn mode of Witherbloom Command, pretty relevant here. And attack with everybody all the same. They're dead. Might as well get everyone into the red zone. Cool. Beating Death and Taxes is important to me. This is kind of a spicy build. I don't know what this green mana's for, and they are a deep enough commitment to black that they have Thoughtseize in their main deck. But this is an important matchup for me to win. On to the next round.
This video is sponsored by Moxfield.com, the easiest way to build Magic decks online. Moxfield supports over 30 formats, including Legacy and everything else you'll see on this channel. There's multiple customizations so you can interact with your deck how you want. Views such as text, grid, or stacks. And groupings like type, subtype, color, color identity, even artist. The site offers light mode, dark mode, and so much more. However you want to see your deck, Moxfield can provide it for you. Follow my Moxfield to keep up with the channel and what I'm playing in paper. I'll see you there.
On the draw, the Mystic Sanctuary is a little awkward, but I am going to keep this Island Ponder situation. You know I can't resist it. Volcanic Island Preordain. Even the Izzet Delver decks are playing Portent over Preordain now. I kind of suspect a Sneak and Show here, and here we are confirming with the Lotus Petal. It's nice when your ideas are immediately rewarded. And this deck is not going to have Wasteland. Ponder, Murktide C, Witherbloom. If Daze doesn't get it done, I just don't get it done here. I do like the land, and I'm going to keep. I do like keeping Ponders versus combo decks, because that makes them think you found what you wanted. Oh, what the hell is this? Oh no, we're just getting Besiege Stormed. Oh, but if they Besiege here, I Daze it. Oh no, they're hooked on Phoenix? Shit, that's really bad. Okay, well, we're going to be facing down a bunch of Phoenixes. This is not a deck I've seen in a long time. Arclight Phoenix, and you just play Brainstorm, whatever. Okay, I'm taking 9 right now. They got me good. I go to 10. I'm drawing Underground Sea, and then I can't play Murktide here. No way they're just going to get me a Brainstorm, right? And eat up a bunch of Phoenixes. I'm going to Ponder. Commit to going to 1. Bayou, Force of Negation, thanks for showing up. I think I have to shuffle this up the Beanstalk, and I cannot come back from that. Okay, great start. Hydro Blast can kill Phoenixes, not really how I want to do that. Nile Spellbomb, 100%. This deck could accelerate a Blood Moon. I don't know if that's the thing they do, but I don't want to lose to it if it is. Surgical, it's almost certainly a Faithless Looting deck. And then Shouldred's Edict. Murderous Cut seemed pretty bad. Fatal Push seems pretty bad. Pernicious Deed for X equals 4 does mop up a Phoenix army. It could happen. I'm the control deck here. Okay, with 3 Hydro Blasts in, I don't think I need Basic Swamp. If they Blood Moon me, I have paths to remove that. Bowmaster actually does seem pretty good. Stifle seems good. Spell Pierce is good. Maybe I'll just go either 2 Hydro Blasts or no Deed. I don't want to cut any more cards, is the problem I'm having currently. Witherbloom Command might not be that good in the matchup, actually. Like, hitting my land drops and filling my graveyard are always relevant, but if it doesn't actually destroy anything in the matchup... Okay, I'm gonna try it like this. Oh, maybe that bat's supposed to be in. This is a combo matchup, and it is kind of a Thoughtseize. Yeah, mulligan to a hand with no mana. I'm going to keep this one and bottom Murktide Regent. And I'm going to fetch Tropical Island to cast Ponder, because I would like any land that I draw to cast this Beanstalk. None of the above. Well, I mean, Surgical is not the worst card I could have in the matchup. I do have to trust Ponder to deliver the land, though. All right, I'll put the shields up and hope that they don't pivot onto like a Wasteland Dragons or a Channeler game plan here. Underground Sea. Ponder. Did not shuffle their library. All right, Ponder, I need you here. Ooh, Wasteland. Wasteland and Daze. Wasteland's actually fine. Do I just put the Daze in my hand, though? And cast Bean on the Wasteland next turn? Yeah, because I'm not going to waste them. Oh, they might be a Daze deck, though. Okay. I'm not going to shuffle my library. I'm going to play Wasteland and then not use it. I would like to cast this Beanstalk, and then we can talk about the rest of the game after that. Thoughtsies, stop it. Okay, well, resolves. I have multiple ways to annoy their graveyard. They might just take the Beanstalk here and make me use all these answers on them. I would prefer they take anything else, though. Literally anything else. They took Force, okay. That does make Beanstalk a little worse, but I do still need to draw my way out of this. And another Ponder. They don't know that I'm drawing Daze, which is actually huge to have a free counterspell after they think they just stripped a free counterspell. I have some concerns about them being a Dark Ritual deck, and maybe they can just outmuscle a Daze here, but I'm just going to hope they can. Land number 3, Rainstorm. They are fetching basic islands, but that's because I have Wasteland in play, not because they play Blood Moon. At least I don't think so. Lotus Petal. Well, they might Lotus Petal Blood Moon me here. That would be funny. Paradigm Shift. Ooh, you're suddenly a different deck altogether. Oh, Paradigm Shift puts a lot of cards into their deck, but one of them's Thoughtseize. And I'm holding a Thoughtseize, that if I can Thoughtseize you and take your Thassa's Oracle, you're in trouble. Okay, that resolves. That's fine. And maybe it's not fine. Maybe it's terrible, but I am going to try to just find a black source and clear the Thoracle from their hand, because their deck does not win the game. So their hand must have a plan to do that. Dang. Underground Sea, Thoughtseize. Show me that Thassa's Oracle and concede, please. Brainstorm in response. I'll Daze that. And they're done. Okay, cool. That was a little dicey, but we did get there. I think the bat should be in more than the Pernicious Deed. I noticed that after I hit submit in the last round. Carpet of Flowers. They did play a lot of islands that game. But they're not really denying my mana, so maybe that doesn't matter. Okay, Deep Cavern Bat, it is. Send it. And we just figured out what their anti-graveyard hate juke is, and it's Thassa's Oracle. I will keep this hand. Even knowing they have a juke, I'm still interested in having Nile Spellbomb around. I am just going to play it right now. If they daze, they daze. If they pierce, they pierce. They dazed, okay. Hopefully that at least sets them back a turn. Brainstorm with their floating mana. Effective. Okay, please don't dumpster me. I don't like my spot all of a sudden. Looted Delta. And Ponder. Okay, that's not so bad. Orcish Bowmaster. I'm going to play Bayou and pass here. Hydroblast might be good. Bowmaster might be good. I don't think tapping out for Beanstalk is how I want to do this. Oh, I actually should have played my Misty Rainforest shit. Because if I have to brainstorm into, like, Spell Pierce or some other thing, that is not going to work. Okay, dazing my Bowmaster on the Preordain. That is two spells this turn. If they can Dark Ritual the thing, they're going to get me here. Bottom, bottom, the Preordain. No, don't do more! Shit! Damn it! Alright. Now I'm going to lose. No Surgical in my hand. Maybe I fuck that. The Bayou is actually just devastating, because now I have no chance of Murktide. I had the Spell Pierce. It was there. I mean, they had Daze, so maybe that doesn't matter, but... Oh, no. Okay. Brainstorm. Try to solve this problem. Oh, the bat. It's here. What do I do here? I need to kill an Arclight Phoenix and then get Murktide into play. I'll be at 5 life. I can't bat this turn. I could bat plus Murktide next turn. If I'm willing to get rid of Beanstalk and Ponder here, is Ponder worse than Spell Pierce? Maybe. Ponder, land. I have to fetch, unfortunately. Hydroblasting in combat means they're not going to Phoenix me, or they can't refire the Phoenix, but it might mean that they draw a counterspell. All right, we're in the beginning of combat now. I'm going to kill a Phoenix, I hope. Then I go to 4. Okay. I can bat plus Murktide here, and I have Daze protection. All right, big bats. Earn your keep. Lifelink creature. And the Thoughtseize. My opponent's hand is blanks. Grab a tropical island, shove Murktide. Okay, opponent has all lands in hand. Please don't draw Lightning Bolt. Volcanic Island. No attacks past the turn? Or do they want to eat the bat? They do not. Okay. Okay. I still don't have attacks here. I think it's better to leave bat back. I do lose if they just draw Lightning Bolt. I'm not even sure if that's a card in their deck, but it is very good against me. If I can get this second Murktide into play, we're in good shape. Come on! If I attacked with the bat... No, but then they just attack bat. Oh my god. I exactly can't interact with this. Alright. Spell Pierce, Daze, concede. What a card to draw. Okay. I am losing to Arclight Phoenix combo in 2023. Damn near 2024. I think it's okay that I didn't have a plan for this, but I mean, my sideboard was full of cards. And I was one life point shy of stabilizing here. Like, if I'm just at 4 instead of 3, I think I win this game every time. Okay, I mean, whatever. It was close. On to the next round.
If you're looking to run a CEDH or 1v1 tournament, Eminence Gaming has your back with Command Tower. With Command Tower's intuitive tournament manager dashboard, you can handle decklist submission and player management with just a few clicks. Players just need to scan the event's QR code for access to the full tournament bracket, including seamless pairings and real-time standing updates. Take the guesswork out of tournament organizing. Try Command Tower for your next event.
I am on the play for round number 3. I'm going to keep my hand. Needs another land, but that's what Brainstorm is for. A bad lands. Good sign to have Force of Will in my hand. Oh, Dragon's Rage Channeler. That's not what I thought was going to come out of a Badlands. I think I'm just going to Fatal Push this. Underground Sea, Fatal Push. Can I draw a fetch land? No. Okay, Brainstorm. Don't betray me. Brainstorm betrayed me. Up the Beanstalk and Sauron's Ransom. Probably the way around. Sauron's Ransom, Up the Beanstalk on top. My opponent mauled a 6 and played Badlands. That's not a Wasteland. Jund? Is Jund a deck now? Did nobody tell me? Is Jund back? Faithless Looting. Okay, am I playing against Arclight Phoenix again? I'm going to Daze this Looting, because I know I'm about to miss my land drop anyway. And I don't know what this is setting up, but I'd rather not find out. And if this Ponder finds the land for Murktide, I'm going to feel pretty good against whatever's going on over there. Ponder. Shuffle. 3 things that are not lands. There we go. We're back in it. Another Jund fetch land. What am I worried about here? They can flashback Looting? Is this something I'm worried about? I liked dazing the front half. I don't know if I like 2-for-1-ing myself on the back half. I'm going to let it happen. Now I'm set up. I can play Beanstalk next turn and then Force is a cantrip and then Murktide's a cantrip after that. Holy shit, it is actually Phoenix twice in a league? How is this possible? They've cast one spell this turn, though. It's going to be hard to cast 2 more with no additional mana sources. Yeah, maybe I'll just put Murktide into play then. Though, my green knows no bounds, and I would rather draw a card when I cast my Murktide. Okay, I hope taking this turn off doesn't kill me. But they have not really indicated that they're busting yet. If I had known for sure that this was an Arclight Phoenix deck, I probably actually would have forced a negation to the Looting. A Swamp. Buried Alive. Dragon's Rage Channeler gets to trigger here. This only searches for creatures. Search for 3 creature cards. Okay. I'm going to let this resolve, and then I can force a Dark Ritual. If their last cards in hand is like Dark Ritual second spell, I'll cut it off there. They can't search for like 3... Lava Darts, which is what I was thinking about, because that's not how Buried Alive works. Okay, They have the full boat of phoenixes in the bin. I'm about to have a big creature and a handful of forces. One of the tricks here, though, is they only have to cast three spells. So they don't have to resolve. I just have to find a way to cut them off wherever I can. Orcish Bowmaster, not this turn. Big Murktide, draw a card. Found an island, that's great. That turns on spell pierce. Yeah, if they just, like, bolt me three times here, I'm in trouble. Land grant shit, that's a spell. Milled a Bowmaster. Oh, they showed me their hand. So they can Seek the Beast here, and they have a Bowmaster. I have to counter the Seek the Beast. Oh, there's a Faithless Looting in the graveyard, too. Oh no, they can do everything. Son of a bitch. Okay, that was a good land grant. Do I let them Seek the Beast, or do I make them Faithless Looting? Do I think they're going to forget that they have Faithless Looting in the graveyard? Probably not. Force Exiling. Do I want a Force of Will or Negation here? I mean, the Force of Will at least draws a card. All right, Force of Will, Exiling, Force of Negation. Because, I mean, we're done with spells here. And if they Bowmaster this draw trigger, then they don't get to Faithless Looting. And I'm actually cool with that. This might incentivize them to misplay. They didn't fall for it. Okay. They're going to get all four phoenixes back. I'm going to take 10 in combat. Do I care about spell piercing this? Everything that could go wrong is already in the graveyard. Yeah, I suspect they're just going to keep all the same cards. Yeah. All right. Yeah, Bowmaster's still in their hand. Glad I didn't waste spell pierce, but I am going to 5. Oh, that land grant was devastating. I actually forgot. I'm not going to lie. I forgot that land grant reveals your hand when you cast it. If I had looked and seen that they had exactly enough mana to Seek the Beast, if I force the land grant and force the Seek the Beast, then they can't do this. So I actually threw it here. Fetch land, what does that do? How do I stabilize here? Not with the cards that I have. So I guess I start with a brainstorm. That's more of the same cards that I already had. All right, I'm dead. Lost to Arclight Phoenix twice in a row. Nile Spellbomb. Veil of Summer. Deep Cavern Bat. Surgical Extraction. Hydro Blast. Okay, yeah. I definitely punted that. If I look at their hand and I force, then they're out of spells and they can't do anything. Threw it right in the trash. Shieldred's Edict seems bad. Murderous Cut seems bad. I can't go totally out of removal because they're not a fully dedicated combo deck. The Dragon's Rage Channeler and the Druid are both relevant game pieces. If I cut Daze and Force of Negation, that's less I have against their most explosive draws, but I'm bringing in Nile Spellbomb Surgical Extraction. Yeah, I think I want to try it like this, and I'll remember to look at their hand if they cast their spell again. I'm going to keep this because it does have access to Beanstalk. Bayou Pass, Taiga, Dragon's Rage Chandler, cycle for Underground Sea. And I'm going to invest in my Beanstalk here. Sauron's Ransom. Okay, don't kill me this turn. I could have played this much more carefully. Like, if I ponder here, I see way more cards than Beanstalk does. Second Channeler. If they Dark Ritual Buried Alive Land Grant here, I could be in some trouble. Okay. I would be surprised if they name... Oh, well, they just raw milled an Arclight Phoenix. Hate that for me. Okay. They'll probably name, like, Force or Surgical on the front here, and then they can sack a Dragon's Rage Channeler if they want to clear my double Murktide or whatever. Surgical Extraction, yep. Not present. I don't think that name makes sense because they milled a Phoenix. I would have Surgicaled it before the Therapy resolved. And this is two spells. If they have a land grant, they can trigger this Phoenix. Because Therapy, Flashback Therapy, that's two. Okay, here's the Therapy coming back again. Probably going to try to get their 2-for-1 on Murktide Regent. Yep, those are gone. Okay, now what happens? I can Sauron's Ransom, or I can Brainstorm and then Ponder. I think I'm going to Brainstorm. I'd love a removal spell. Yeah, there's one. Cool. Put back. And I think the Spell Pierce will be good someday. Put back Ponder, Brainstorm. Keep the Sauron's Ransom. Tropical Island, Orcish Bowmaster. I'm doing this now before they get Delirium. If they Bowmaster my Bowmaster, it's fine. I'll figure that out later. But taking away their card selection when they've not done much yet feels good.
And now if they Faithless Looting, they get domed. Okay, opponent's just passing. That's great. Hello? They're going Murktide. I'm going to attack. I think they would have main phased Orcish Bowmaster if they had that. And I'll just pass with Spell Pierce available, or I can Sauron's Ransom if I need to dig for something better. They're just passing again. Ransom. Opponent did not click through it immediately. Doesn't look like I'm getting four cards this time. Witherbloom Command Island versus two mystery cards. Witherbloom Command's not even good. I'm going to take the face down pile. Ooh, I get a Ring Bearer. I would like my Orc Army to be my Ring Bearer. My hand has two forces in it. That's pretty good. With this pile of beans that I have. Speaking of beans, I'm going to get more of them right now. Not on my watch. Force pitching. I'm going to pitch Ponder. I have enough cards. Ooh, Thoughtseize, what's up? It's all coming up my way. Wasteland too. All right, Thoughtseize you. What's going on over there? What you been holding on to? Dark Ritual, two Buried Alives, and a Lightning Bolt. I'm going to take the Dark Ritual and then also waste them off black. That's pretty bad for them. They were actually there if I didn't have counter spells. That was the three spells and all the Phoenixes. Okay, does the more creature-heavy version of this dictate Murderous Cuts, Pernicious Deeds, anything of the sort that I didn't have otherwise? Where would I put this Pernicious Deed if I bring it in my deck? What's the cut? Is the Batch as bad against a Bowmaster deck? X1, kind of tough. But they're also a combo deck. And they have flying creatures that I like blocking. And just looking at their hand is valuable. Because then you know what you need to pressure. Maybe I cut a Wasteland, actually. Seems weird to cut a land while also adding a card that costs a lot of mana, but I'm going to try it. I don't think Mana Denial is really my plan A against them. This hand looks great. Force of Will and Graveyard Hate. Keep. Burden Catacombs. Thoughtseize. All right, well, Thoughtseize is going to resolve. Having a handful of interaction like this, like, I don't think Nile Spellbomb is standalone good enough to be worth forcing a Thoughtseize over. I do think it's the best card in my hand, and my opponent agreed, but I don't think it's worth two cards. Land, go. They know I have this wall of interaction up, and I'm going to cycle Lore and Reveal in the end step. Underground Sea, go get Tropical Island, get all my colors. I'm ready to party. They could play Bowmaster here. Does that dissuade me from pondering? I don't think so. I'm not a coward. Leaving up green, there's one Veil of Summer in my deck. Leaving up black, there's one Thoughtseize in my deck. And there's also Fatal Pushes. I'm going to ponder. Land, Bowmaster, more blue cards. I will take the land and stack the orc underneath it. Ball Therapy. Don't like that. Spell Pierce it. They could play a creature here and Flashback Therapy with that creature. Faithless Looting. This is spell number 2. I don't really want this to happen. I also like having a bunch of counter spells in my hand, because if they discard two Phoenixes, then play Land Grant. The Land Grant is just such a beating at all points. These cards are coming directly from their hand, though. Okay, I'm gonna bet against. My Murktide can beat one or two Phoenixes in combat, even if they do have discard a Phoenix, play Land Grant here. It's not a huge game-breaking deal. It's just, like, good. And if this Faithless Looting just discards two cards that aren't Phoenix, then it was actively card disadvantage for them. Yeah, Land Grant, Dark Ritual in the bin. Sick. Played around it. I play my land, hold up my Bowmaster, and continue holding up my wall of interaction. Maybe shoving Murktide's actually better than Bowmaster here. They're just dead so fast, and I have Hydroblast to protect it. I'll drop my Bowmaster in the end step, see if I can sniff out something from them. They didn't have a Bowmaster a turn or two ago, but they've Faithless Looting since then. Not gonna lie, I forget what my card under the bottom of the Ponder is. Just gonna shuffle it away and assume the worst. Another Bowmaster. Lightning Bolt target Bowmaster. That's fine. That's not what I'm about here. I'm gonna save this Hydroblast for Pyroblast. And shove Murktide, who should be able to win the game pretty quick here, and should have been in play last turn. Snuff out. Smart. Am I more worried about getting the game over quickly or Phoenixes coming into play? I'm just not even worried about Phoenixes at this point. I am going to force to try to get the game over. They're at 10 from the snuff out. Orc army kills my orc army. That's fine. They got one card left in their hand. Alrighty. Here's the flashback looting. I think I'm still just not worried about that. I'm worried about my Murktide getting pyroblasted. And they've made it clear they didn't have a Phoenix, at least last time they were able to discard cards. Alright, they found one this time. If they land grant snuff out, they can go Hellbent to get Arclight Phoenix into play, but I can Hydro Blast the Phoenix itself and then Bowmaster their Bowmaster, and I'm still just stable. A one Phoenix just isn't that impressive is the problem. Attack for 6, you go to 4, snuff out's off, and I'm just going to hold up the cards that I have. Dark Ritual. Okay, I mean, that's a spell. Thoughtseize. I'm going to Bowmaster in response to the Thoughtseize. Okay, they've conceded to that. Interesting. I wonder if they needed to Faithless Looting to try to make this work. All right, whatever. Well, we did it. Split the difference between the Phoenix decks in the league somehow. On to the next one. You come here to level up at Magic. To level up as a software engineer, check out the YouTube series Dev Better, hosted by the founder of 7-Factor Software and Magic player, Jeremy Duvall. You can also find Jeremy co-hosting episodes 106 and 109 of the Tech Talk series with Keith Shaw on the Tech Talk YouTube channel. Head over to Tech Talk and don't forget to subscribe to 7-Factor's YouTube channel for every episode of Dev Better. On the play in round 4 versus Kahira, a companion I have not seen often in Legacy. Kahira can be in control decks and combo decks, basically. Oh, we've been serum powdered. Okay, combo deck confirmed. Well, I'm going to have to ponder into some action here. Ponder, please find a Force of Will. Murktide Regent Fatal Push Bowmaster, that's not it. Shuffle a Ponder. And found another Ponder. We might be in trouble. Depends on how explosive they become here. Manifold Key. Voltaic Key. Okay. Land? Shit. Alright, Ponder. I need you. Alright, found a Force of Will at least. I will keep the Force, even though it results in missing a land drop, and my opponent's going to be able to read that too. The Serum Powder exiled a Karn, a Key. Ox Opal. 4 cards left in hand. Assault Monolith. That's not my fight. I'm looking for a Ring. Mystic Forge. I have to fight over this. Force that. And they could just untap Assault Monolith and cast a different 4-drop here. Okay, the untap Monolith didn't play another 4-drop. I can Brainstorm now, see 2 new cards. I think I gotta try to make something happen. Oh no, not like this deck. Why? Why? Why would you do this? Okay, now I lose. They just have to brick for multiple turns, including having active Inventor's Fair. Like, worst case scenario, they activate Inventor's Fair this turn and play Ring next turn, and then I die. Cool. Dead. Concede. I saw a lot of cards that turn without finding land number 2. That's, I'm gonna count that under bad beats. We've got Pernicious Deed, Energy Flux, Force of Vigor, Deep Cavern Bat, heck yeah. Powder Keg. They're not really a graveyard deck. They're not really a land-heavy deck. A Turok in the maybe pile. They're not a deck with creatures other than Construct tokens. Yeah, I probably might as well get Turok in here if I can just hit them at some point. It might be good enough. Bowmaster's fine. The forces are good. The flux and the deed are my best stuff. Okay, let's do it. I will keep this hand. It's great. Being able to spell pierce here is so annoying for them. They powdered a hand and then kept 7. Powder exiled 1 forge, 1 ring, 1 Karn. One of everything. The sampler platter. Defense grid. I'll spell pierce that and then just wasteland them probably. Murktide Regent. Maybe Force of Will plus Bowmaster is a better way to spend this turn. Because if they do something like play Urza Saga, Wasteland might actually have a better target. 3 mana. Salt Monolith. That resolves. Manifold Key can resolve. I don't like that all these spells are resolving. I don't like that all these spells are happening. But I'm going to do what I can. Karn. Okay, so if Karn minuses, I can just kill it. If it pluses, I'm in trouble. Resolves. I'm just going to hope they get greedy. Just wish for, like, anything here. Okay, they made a wish. For the one ring. Okay. I was just going to flash Bowmaster in as a little bit of damage on this board, but this ended up being a pretty good exchange. They got like a air quotes free card out of it in the ring. Waste the Saga, play the Sea, and getting closer to this Murktide. Yeah, they do have to take two off Ancient Tomb to untap their thing. Not anymore. Tapping Ancient Tomb is still part of the plan here, though, for them. And do I brainstorm? I'm just thinking about how I get Murktide Regent into play next turn. I definitely force here, but thinking about brainstorming also. Also brainstorm on my turn. That's just more looks for Thoughtseize. Okay, that fetch was good. Turok and Beanstalk. Turok not going to show up in time. Put back these two things. Now the question is, do I just shove Murktide and try to race over the finish line? Or do I play up the Beanstalk? I think I play Murktide. The Ancient Tomb is part of their mana here. And if they just have another way to check me, I'm going to fail the next check they play. But now I can bash Karn with a big creature. The ring is the card that I'm worried about. But I do have Bowmaster that pressures ring starting next turn. There is a ring. And they can draw three cards here. I have to ping my Orc army because they have protection. And they're passing the turn. Oh, there's a force. All right, deck, please draw a blue card right now off this bean. Oh, yeah. Always had it, deck. Good job. They go to 8 in their upkeep from the ring trigger. And they have to work through the Bowmaster protection somehow, or the Bowmaster pings somehow while they draw their deck. Saga gets to tutor. So I don't know what my opponent, like, I don't know their life. I don't know a lot of information here, but nothing that's happening in this deck right now makes me think that Kihira is better than a sideboard slot. This is a thing that happens, a conversation that occurs often in the comments on my channel. It's like, why not Kihira? Why Kihira? And I guess if you get null rotted, but how are you getting green-green or white-white if you get null rotted? Is there a single elemental or cat or dinosaur or nightmare or beast in your deck that you're buffing in any way? I don't know, maybe it's great, but this is not free, and I feel like this is a deck that would want 15 sideboard cards because it is kind of a glass cannon, and answering things like Null Rod seems like something you'd want to be doing with your sideboard. They tutored for a Manifold Key. This is a lot of mana. They can activate their ring one more time without dying. They're untapping Basalt Monolith. 8 cards in hand is a lot. If I force a Paradox Engine here, or force a replacement ring, that's where I actually want to be. Drew a card off the bean. Okay, that is... I actually wished for the ring that they serum powdered away. So this is still 3 rings answered, not 4, even though we did see 4 of them throughout the game. Okay, can they win now? I'll take a key. They can certainly make a lot of mana right now. And they still have a lot of cards in hand. This will be 5 mana. If they have Paradox Engine and another way to win, they could get there. Another key. If they have Aetherflux Reservoir, they could just gain a ton of life here. Okay, they cashed in their last ring activation that they get. This also turns off Ancient Tomb as a mana source. Did they get there? They did not. Okay, that was a tight one. Winter Orb, Nile Spell Bomb, Surgical Extraction. I don't think any of those are things I want. Sheltered Edict can remove Karn, which is 1/3 of the threats in their deck. Maybe that's better than Turok. Okay, yeah, I'll pivot that a little bit. And let's do this now. So this hand is the Stinkos. Just doesn't do anything. I don't think Daze is going to save me. Mulligan. This hand is better. I'll keep it and bottom. I think I actually bottom Ponder here. The option of leave up Spell Pierce or cycle for Thoughtseize looks pretty good. Witherbloom Command has text in the matchup. I hate that they're going first. I hate that they kept 7. Manifold Key resolves. All right, a pretty anemic turn 1. I'll take it. And holding up Spell Pierce plus Daze to survive the turn into Thoughtseize. Saga. I will pierce the defense grid to keep on my counter spells for the rest of the game. Draw for turn. Oh, the bat. It's here. I'm going to find an underground sea and see what's going on over there. Karn monolith. All right, I'm taking Karn. They have a ass ton of mana and multiple sagas, so I'm going to need Deed to stabilize here. Oh, I would love it if they played Grim Monolith right now. Because if I daze this, daze is not getting better this game. Yeah, I daze this, they have to tap Urza's Saga, and then they lose out on constructs either way. That's fine. Cool. Oh, did you draw a payout 4-drop? Stop it. Or no, you just have another key in your hand. Please. I'm begging you. I need this. There's the key. 4 mana in the pool. Untapping Monolith's free here. They actually have a thing. Oh, Paradox Engine. Well, not great for me. If I draw Wasteland, that's not bad. Powder Keg. Oh. Destroy each artifact and creature with a mana value equal to the number of things. Okay, that can be a next turn problem, I think. And right now I'm going to Witherbloom Command to destroy Grim Monolith and mill myself, try to find a land. Mill myself, destroy Grim Monolith. Black, found a Polluted Delta to play. Force of Vigor in the graveyard now. Okay, I need them to whiff, basically. They do get a tutor, but I took away their thing worth untapping. Okay, they made a construct. Urza's Workshop is online, by the way. Tapping for some extra mana. This might be a game where we see them wish for Kahira. What a fool I am. Expedition map. Yikes. That gets either another saga or a Inventor's Fair, and then they pop off. But it looks like they've committed to a turn of saga-related element rather than using the map. Draw for turn, Force of Will, so close to being useful. I'm just going to play Powder Keg and pass. This at least clears the construct tokens, even though it does let them pivot onto the expedition map. Okay, they're still committing constructs to the board. Saga trigger, moment of truth. What are we doing? Okay, they're just passing priority. That's really smart. A lot of people don't know that you can do this. If I just pass priority on this, because a lot of people will float the mana, and at that point you can't unfloat. But now if they search for Pithing Needle, they keep both constructs, and if I don't pop first, and then they get to make a construct because they kept one back. I hate when opponents play well. It's just not fair. I'm going to fetch I think I want Tropical Island here. This Tropical Island lets me put Force of Vigor on top of my deck and then also play it. I don't know if I have time for all that, but I'm going to try. They tutored Mox Opal. Now they actually have something that makes mana under the Paradox Engine. Expedition map. Okay, they're just committed to sagas. Not going for the Inventor's Fair line at all. Pernicious Deed is in my deck somewhere. Fingers crossed. Ooh, Force Blue card. Bats off to you. Show me your hand. It's an Urza's Workshop. Mystic Sanctuary, put Force of Vigor on top of my deck. Okay. We are tentatively stable here. Do I want to block or do I want to start gaining life on the backswing? Yeah, I'll just take 5. It might be 6 by the time they activate it. All right, just 5 coming through. And I will attack for 1 lifelink. Heck yeah, Deep Cavern Bat. It has yet to take a card from an opponent. But it certainly has been cast. They make a construct now. They can make a construct next turn. Yeah, I really do just have to Force a Vigor 2 constructs here. There's not that much removal in my deck. And then just hope that Paradox Engine doesn't get anything going. Do I think there's a Welding Jar in this deck? I hope not. I'm going to let this resolve. Lotus Petal. Okay. God, come on. That fourth saga just drew it. There it is. Okay. I need a Pernicious Deed real bad. Force of Vigor, destroy the 2 constructs that are coming at me. All right, deck, Pernicious Deed, give it to me, right off the top. Murktide Regent, oh, can I just kill them before they get constructs happening? Manifold Key can make construct unblockable anyway, so I'm not really holding anything back here. The options now are ponder, try to find exactly Pernicious Deed, or shove this Murktide. I might be able to do both. If ponder ends up in a blue card, Oh, Wasteland's in my deck too. Oh, sick. Wasteland. We did it. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Wasteland, take out your Saga. Attack with my bat, because your creature's unblockable anyway. And then next turn, I can Edict the Construct token and play Murktide. Or I can hold up Force of Will for another turn. Yeah, that's probably better. Okay, they are playing a Defense Grid, second main, which makes the Construct bigger. So it does untap it. They have the Inventor's Fair. Jesus, I just can't catch a break here. Okay, I'm going to have to hold up Force of Will for a turn. They just tutor a One Ring. They can't use it now. That's lucky. And I'm going to have to pitch my Murktide to the Force, and then I'm drawing Force of Will after that. Ugh, this did not work out well. The lifelink's adding up, though. We're in there. Yeah, I cannot let this ring resolve. It's not an option. So if they draw just an artifact, I lose anyway. Okay, I'm dead. If I Force, Yeah, I'm just dead no matter what. All right, GG. That was so frustrating. Just slightly over the top there, and it took drawing all four Urza Sagas to get to that point. Tough beats. This is a Force check deck, and I don't have infinite Forces, though. On to the final round.
The official BoshNRoll Island Ponder Keep shirt is available exclusively through Coalesce Apparel. This Magic player-owned business is a staple of our community. They keep this channel on the air, and it's my pleasure to partner with them for this product. Coalesce is the best Magic apparel on the market. They have awesome new designs coming out all the time. Use code BoshNRoll to get 10% off your order only at coalesceapparel.shop.
On the play in the final round, Island Ponder. Got some interaction, got a threat. I'm going to get Underground Sea and cast my Ponder. Found a land, found a Spell Pierce. I will take the land and pass. Ancient Tomb. Chalice on 1. Okay, so Spell Pierce is the top card of my deck right now. I wish it was in my hand. Maybe I sacked that Ponder wrong. That would have been a perfect superfluous blue card to send here. I do have Bowmaster Murderous Cut. I could keep Force in my hand and then work my way up to Murktide. I'm going to let this resolve. Okay, passing the turn. Grove of the Burn Willows. What is going on over there? Blood Sun. Lands lose all abilities except mana abilities. Okay, that does not affect much here. It turns off my fetch lands, but this is also a cantrip. I can get an extra ping off you from Bowmaster. Okay. Weird game, but I'm committed to it. Wasteland doesn't have any abilities. Unlucky. I'm one short of Murktide here. I can just fire Brainstorm into the Chalice if they don't give me something to Force. Witherbloom Command is in my deck. Chrome Mox. Pitching Yokel Hops. Oh my god. This is what's going on in the 2-2 bracket on Moto Leagues. Chandra, Heart of Fire. Well, I'm going to Force that. I'm not even going to read it. Not interested. Fatal Push. Attack for 3. Murktide. Okay. Are they going to Yokel Hops me, or am I going to win? Those are the options here. I should probably read this card, actually. Ensnaring Bridge. Yikes. What's my out to that? Nothing. They do have two cards in their hand. They have one card in their hand. They can, up the Beanstalk, and I'll play it. Force of Will is in my hand now. I just have to, ping them with Bowmasters to win the game. Or if they fail to get their hand empty, I can attack with two creatures. All right. It's my turn now. I'm going to attack with both of these. If they go to 2, they can't tap Ancient Tomb anymore. Yeah, all right, had to think about it. Okay, and I guess I just play out the Mystic Sanctuary. I am very close to Hardcast Force of Will. Backup Ensnaring Bridge, okay. This Bowmaster is still representing no more Ancient Tomb. Hey, here's that boy, you're at 2. You're actually at 1. You don't know that. They gotta get their hand all the way empty here. Even Yokel Hops doesn't save them. Yeah, got him. Okay, we're against Yokel Hops Stompy. Hydro Blast, excellent here. I like Powder Keg. I like Basic Swamp. I like Pernicious Deed. Force of Vigor. Deep Cavern Bat. Heck yeah. Fatal Push, Murderous Cut. We did see a big stupid Planeswalker. Sheldred's Edict might be worth the squeeze here. Although Orcish Bowmaster did win me that game, I don't think it's necessarily good in the matchup. Stifle seems kind of questionable. Maybe I play one Edict. I have my Hydro Blast and Forces. I don't want to be too laden on random discard spells or random removal spells. Maybe Energy Flux is supposed to be in here too. Yeah, I actually think Energy Flux should be in. My bad. My hand contains Force of Will. I'm going to keep it. They have Shatter Skull. Oh, nice. Love that card. I'm going to get Tropical Island and play Ponder. I have Lorien Revealed if I find myself in a position where I need Basic Island. Do I want Basic Swamp? I could fetch Basic Swamp. Putting Murktide in my hand is another blue card. All right, I will actually keep this Ponder. Chrome Mox resolves. Pitching a Yokel. Blood Sun. This turns off my fetch land, and that does make a lot of stuff worse. Yeah, I am actually going to fight over this Blood Sun. And I'm going to fetch Basic Swamp with my Polluted Delta, just in case. And Witherbloom Command. Target player mills 3. You get something back, and I'm going to destroy their Chrome Mox. Do I want to mill me or mill them? I'll mill me. Murktide Regent is literally in my hand. Pick up Wasteland here. Yeah, I'll put you to the test on that one. Keep the Mana Denial plan going. Oh, they're just passing the turn. Give me that. I'm going to Wasteland them. Murktide can wait. If my opponent doesn't play a spell or develop a mana source, I'm going to hit him. Those are the rules. Beanstalk. More like Greenstalk, am I right? I'm greedy, though. Chrome Mox. Uh-oh. Pitching another Yokel Hops. And they had a... Alright, they found a Blood Sun. That means I can't Wasteland them. Do I cycle Lorien Revealed? Yeah, I'm going to cycle Lorien Revealed for my Basic Island. And then I can Beanstalk plus Murktide here. Lorien is a blue card in case I find a force, but I'm trying to just bury my opponent here. Mystic Sanctuary doesn't work anyway, so I'll just exile all my spells. Force of Vigor, hey! I'm going in the upkeep. Hit your mana source and your Blood Sun. And they're dead. Cool. Alright. Weird League. Played against Arclight Phoenix twice, a card that I have not seen in 6 months in any deck. Not perfect play from me. Some Ponder stacking issues, like that last round where I wish I had put Spell Pierce in my hand because the land is coming anyway and the blue card might matter. And then that Jund game, the one game they got off me, they showed me their hand with Land Grant and I just didn't bother to look at it. And then they ended up triggering their spells when I actually had a deterministic lock to let them not do that. The deck felt good, though. I felt like I had game in every matchup, which is very important to me. Even the ones we lost were close, and with tighter play or drawing slightly better, sideboard configuration, like, it's all within the realm of I want to be able to play every game, and I want to be proactive when that's appropriate, and I want to be able to sit back when that's appropriate. And this deck does do all of those things. Deep Cavern Bat, I don't know about you. We didn't see the matchup that it's really air quotes for, but I did bring it in a lot. It still remains my default for Eternal Weekend if I don't figure out anything else between now and then. I probably have about 48 hours from the time of recording this to really lock in a deck and just start to become one with it. And this league was inspiring. It's a 3-2 result, same as the PO deck that I'm not playing, same as the Cephalid Breakfast deck that I'm probably not playing. But it was a 3-0 that felt good versus a 3-0 that felt bad. And that's an important difference to me. Everybody, thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Check out the Patreon where I do always post my list before tournaments. If you've been watching this testing series and you just must know what I played at Eternal Weekend, you could have known if you were in the Patreon. Hit that button. I'm out of here. I'll see you next time.